right, man.
We just got done eating an awesome breakfast. Would you guys agree?
Oh, fantastic.
But what'd we eat? What'd we eat?
Oh, you did it special for us.
Come on.
Wild boar sausage.
Biscuits and gravy with wild boar sausage.
Yep.
Actually, it was a sow. That one was a sow. Remember that one? We got that one just for the meat. We like to shoot those boars, but you guys agree the sows are good?
Oh, it's delicious.
I got to tell you, when you got sows, you got boars. So we go out there and we put out the ground blind in a place that, you know, there was a lot of runs going through there by the water, and the hogs were coming in there rooting and bedding and wallering and all that stuff. So what'd we do with Bruce?
Sent Bruce out to scout and look for hogs. He's all over going on their side by side, all over. We watch him go down the trails by us, back and forth.
I'm watching Bruce over there about 1,000 yards, and I'm thinking any minute the hog is going to come out of there. And actually, Guy just nudged you, didn't he?
Yeah,
he nudged Kevin.
Well, we were all looking.
We were looking the wrong way.
Yeah, because Bruce said that they would probably come down the hill to water. So yeah. You and I were looking up this way, and then Guy.
We were sitting on the water hole.
Yeah, and then Guy kind of.
When I looked and saw, I mean, this is a big hog right here. This is 400 plus pounds right here.
Kevin's was bigger.
He was
bigger.
Yeah,
when I looked over there and saw how tall that thing was, he saw the blind.
When that pig, he was just feeding, and he come out of the woodlot, and he was probably headed down the water, but he literally was just kind of walking along, and he was feeding, and we all three saw him at the same time. He looked right at the blind and tipped his head.
He couldn't smell us. We had deer dander on.
Like, what? That wasn't there yesterday, and this is my territory. And he literally, the three of us sat and watched this hog. He raised his front shoulders up, lowered his head.
And his hair stood up.
And he started pawing at the ground like a bull does. And then the next thing you know, he's popping his teeth. When they're irritated, they'll pop those teeth together. The three of us are looking at each other like, he's going to charge the blind.
He was going to charge the blind.
You'll see in the video where he starts making his way towards us kind of, but he couldn't smell us. When he started kind of easing towards us, I remember, I looked up at Dan and I said, he's going to charge the blind. But you can't shoot.
I said, don't let him.
Yeah,
that's what I said.
You can't shoot one of these head on, even if you wanted to try a frontal headshot, because the skulls are so sloped like that, the arrow would have glanced right off. Well, at the last minute, he decided he was going to turn and go around us and try and wind us. Well, when he turned, that's when I took the shot.
What do you think, boss?
This is very unusual.
Got Uncle Kevin with us.
Got Uncle Kevin, senior advisor.
The weather is like 60.
Yeah.
It's crazy cool right now.
Yeah, it feels like opening week. It feels like opening week in Michigan bow hunting in the fall.
Yeah.
Me and Kevin have actually been hunting together for over 40 years.
You started doing commercial videos.
Oh, way before. Kevin actually, back in the day when we had the old 3/4 SP and carrying a studio deck on hunts.
Things have changed. Not your ability to kill, though.
Thank you.
Hey, 10 years at least in the makings, baby. That's Can you believe that?
That's the absolute biggest hog I've ever got.
Have you ever seen anything work out like that? That thing, solitary, he is the dominant boar on this whole
This ground blind hunting's awesome.
I'm shaking. Hey, and I mean, I'm telling you, this guy has been in some big fires and some big crashes.
And he's killed a lot of stuff.
And he's killed a lot of
stuff. I've been on fire, I've been bit by a rattlesnake, and I'm shaking like a leaf.
Yeah, here we go.
Man, Kevin. Now, he's not, and we ain't got to worry about him running.
Yeah, we don't have to do a recovery. We don't have to do a blood trail. We'll just go right to it.
I guarantee you, Kevin, that thing is as big as
me. That was great. He kept coming up like.
I thought he was going to charge us.
I did too.
I really did.
He kept pawing at the ground. His mouth started foaming like that.
Yep.
I thought.
He started popping his teeth.
I thought he was going to charge us.
I did too.
And this blind ain't no intimidation to a hog like that, believe me. I mean, that dude will charge a
vehicle.
I think he was coming around because he couldn't smell us from where he was.
No.
And he was confused at what this was.
Yeah. And he was contemplating whether he was going to run over us or go around
us. Exactly. Well, we can go there now and check him out.
And we gave him an answer to his question.
We answered the call.
I'm shaking as bad as you are, Kevin.
Let's go right to him. Okay. That's mine. That's cool. I'm rolling right now.
Man, Kevin. That's what I'm talking about.
Good job, buddy. Yep.
Kevin, that's bigger than I thought. Whoa! Whoa! Look at that. I'm no sissy, but I'm telling you what.
That is an awesome hog right
that
there.
That is.
Oh, my gosh.
Little teeth. Little teeth, guy.
That is a good one, man. Well, congratulations, man. Was it worth all these years waiting?
Whoa.
Yeah, we got to get a lot of photos with this, man. Well, what's interesting is Bruce just came over here and said, well, you're probably going to have to move the blind because there ain't no activity over here. The thing that I like about Bruce and Alan is they're hands-on guys. They're not prima donnas. They don't have everybody doing everything for them. They do it themselves.
The first time we ever met Alan, he was in the butcher shop cutting up hogs for customers.
Yeah.
Load it up. Let's go.
Okay.
Yeah. You said that's a lot of land. I said I'm a lot of guys.
Oh yeah. That's a lot
of
land.
That's a lot of land. But I'm a lot of guys.
This is a lot
too.
Of land. I'll tell you what.
That's why we hunt.
Hey, and I gotta tell you, while we were on the hunt down there in Tennessee, all you guys out there that volunteered and donated your inside tenderloins for us to make up these sausages like this, and all you guys that got to cook with us and eat with us, that was awesome, man.
Oh, man.
This is how we roll, man. Nothing but Frank sauerkraut.
Thanks, Katie.
We take these on the road with us, and this is how we pull into a truck stop, break out on a tailgate, and people think we're there selling this stuff as a meal. We could make a good living.
Especially if they're fans.
Then and they all are.
Anybody with a camo hat on.
There's some mustard right there. That's enough, too. Man, it's not, these get crunchy?
It's cold. It's 26 or 7 out here right now. It's pretty cold.
Well, here, you just...
Good job on that kill, Kevin.
Thank you.
You did awesome, man.
That dude didn't go, what, 25 yards?
I wish everybody could be right here right now. This is what average American can relate to right here. This isn't a big multi-million-dollar hunting lodge. Chef Swa's in there doing all the buffet dinner and everybody's got a little glass of wine. This is how the guys that we hunt with do it right here.
45 years now.
And up at our primitive deer camp, it has no heat, no lights, no water, no nothing.
Bucket to pee and poop in.
We would go up there on a Monday, let everybody get cleared out for the weekend hunting. Go up there on a Monday with a couple of potatoes and some oil. We had to get a deer. So we didn't worry about it being a Boone and Crockett.
Right, man.
Now, we got what, in the next 3 or 4 days, we're going to go to our honey hole and try to get some more deer down.
Look at this.
Awesome.
Oh, awesome.
That 12 pointer's still there. We got to go get him.
Yeah. I saw him.
40 inch back straps.
I saw him and a 10 and those 3/8 that we got on the camera and a 6 pointer. Yep. I got to tell you. Now's the time to talk about it.
And then we'll show all that on here on Sportsman Channel.
You got to let this happen right now. We're up in a stand. We got corn cut in front of us. Me and Kevin are in the woods about 20 yards. We see this beautiful 8-pointer circling around behind the pond, going around. He comes out in the edge of the cut corn. We're waiting about 15 minutes. We hear this crashing going on in the corn, and out comes this 6-pointer on his side. That 8-pointer threw him out in the opener. So he's walking right down in front of us. I could have shot him at, what, how far was that? Ten yards? 10 yards. But we're waiting. This is what happens when you get caught up in them antlers. I said, Kevin, let him go by, man. That 8-pointer is going to follow him. Guess what? That 8-pointer went in that corner and never came out.
Didn't kill anything.
Didn't get anything that day. Well,
we didn't have fresh back straps for Nora because of that decision.
That's what happens, though. But we're going to get him. We're going to get that 8-pointer before we're done, too.
Look at the tusks.
Yeah,
holy cow. When you see it on the live hog, they don't, you know, they're not sticking out that much because they got so much meat and so much, you know, head to them. But man, that's unbelievable.
This, I got to say hats off to the people at the Mission, that make the Mission crossbows, the Matthews Bow Company. Everybody from the top CEO down to the guy that puts the label on the box and ships it. This is an engineering marvel right here.
Everything
they touch.
I'm going
to tell you this.
Bolt the scope on the mount, load an arrow in it, 3 adjustments, and it was ready to shoot. Unbelievable. I've taken a 12 point with this bow.
Grab your cell phone.
I took this 12 point with this Mission crossbow.
Michigan 12 pointer.
In Michigan. Yep, Michigan 12 pointer.
I'm going to tell off on him when he's done talking.
And I'm telling you, the accuracy that can be achieved with these. You hear a lot about how they'll out of the box shoot 100 yards, but the accuracy that you can achieve with these makes a more humane and quick kill possible for, you know, like people like us, the older. I've had this arm rebuilt. It opens up a whole new world, and it's exciting.
And it gets the youngsters involved.
I have 5 grandkids. And every one of my grandkids right now can take this Mission crossbow out.
And they have this year.
And they already have, yeah. And
they all got a buck.
I put balloons on a target. And if they shoot the red balloon, they get a Jolly Rancher. If they shoot their yellow balloon, they get a like a Tootsie Roll Pop, you know. And we make a game
out of
it.
What do they have to shoot to get one of these?
They got to shoot the real thing.
Yeah.
Dan just reiterated on the youth hunting. It's equipment like this that makes it possible for them to have fun and make a humane, quick kill right here. There's so many young people nowadays that have never even held a recurve, let alone shoot one. They'll never know the experience that we have had.
Yep.
You came over there to that children's cancer research at Jacob Andrew and brought that archery shooting and all that stuff over there.
On behalf of Outdoor Sportsman Group.
Yep, on behalf of Outdoor Sportsman Group. Man, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, and we all do. We all participated in that. Hey, all you guys out there in Facebook land, TV land, all the land, wherever you are, we're out here today with this BXR Matthews. What an awesome bow. And you guys know we're hardcore enough that I just picked this bow up out of the snow. We left it laying out here, which, maybe you wouldn't do that to your brand new high dollar bow like that, but that's what we do because we hunt in those kind of conditions. And it's coming a blizzard out here today, and you can see it's really coming down. But we wanted to show you that if you hunt in these kind of conditions, don't worry about it. Matthews makes a bow that'll do the job no matter what the weather conditions are. So here we go. This is a brand new bow. Rest is already froze up on this thing, man. We got ice on the arrow. Listen to this. Arrow's covered in ice. What are you gonna do? Stay home, stay on the couch? Or are you gonna get out here and do what we do?
Hold that bow still. I wanna show everybody. That's crazy. That is ice, ice, ice. Oh my goodness.
My grandbaby, that's her main thing in life is to eat ice. That's what she says. As soon as she sees Grandpa, Grandpa, ice? Ice?
Hardcore. Right on.
Oh, this thing shoots good, man.
Quiet.
That's how you
so
get
quiet.
That's how you get all of Matthew's bows for all the years we've been with them, and thank you very much, Matt. Man, you guys over there at Matthews really know what you're doing. And I know that Matt is inspired to do these bows. The quality of the equipment
they use.
Second
to none.
Second to none. We travel all over the country. We've done it in every kind of weather. And these Matthews bows have never, ever let us down. And that's the truth.